That's all the information we need, Zach. Let's go back and show them what we found. Seen any of these things before?
No, not that I know of. But that raincoat is a little odd.
Odd? In a town where it rains so much?
Well, the people here rarely go out in the rain. I moved here during high school and I never really understood why. Can you shed some light on this, George?
Oh. There's an old story, folklore. It's a fairy tale to me. Something about a killer in a raincoat who appears on rainy nights. A vicious killer in a bright red raincoat. Just a foolish piece of superstition. A rubbish story someone made up. Not many people still believe it, but I guess it's a traditional place. Most of the shops still close up when it rains. School's out too. Since there's no reason to go out, many people never wear raincoats.
And now the raincoat killer has leapt out from his picture book. Oh, by the way, would you two kindly show me your backs?
Our backs? Is this related to the case?
The person with the upside-down peace mark in that photo we found. He's our killer.
What makes you so sure about that?
Zach and I saw him kill Anna in the lumber mill.
He killed her.
Right in there. Oh, one thing. Please don't mention me about Zach. That's a private matter. Anyway, by showing me your bags, we can clear up most of my concerns about you. Isn't that for the best? You don't want to remove yourselves from the suspect list. It will make things a lot easier.
This is insane. Your methods are rude, insulting, and out of the question. And Emily is a female officer. Forcing her to show you her back is harassment. I don't care if you're an FBI or not. You are out of line.
George, it's okay. Let's just show him and get it over with.
Grandmother, are you crazy?
We flash our backs and he'll start trusting us a little more. Right, Agent York. Are you satisfied now?
Yes.
Now you, George.
Yeah, okay. Can't refuse it now, can I? But don't expect to get your way all the time, Agent Morgan.
George.
These scars, just like your Mr. Zach. Something private. I don't have to tell you about it.
Of course. Just like Zach. We can understand that, right, Zach? Anyway, this will make things a lot easier for you. glad to say you're both pretty much off the hook. Thank you for your cooperation. If anyone is suspicious around here, it's him. He's the most suspicious.
No, I don't think so. But he certainly is the most irritating.
You've studied the crime scene. You know what we have to do next. George, can we arrange to have the town folk gather in one place? There are some things I want to address with the town folk.
Very well. I'll arrange to have as many as possible gather in the community center tomorrow.
Thank you, George. Welcome back, everyone.
Thomas. Agent Morgan, it's past 2100. Let's meet up again at the community center tomorrow. I haven't been sleeping much since this all started, to be honest. I'm exhausted.
I was just about to suggest the same thing.
I'll make arrangements for people to gather between 1500 and 1700. I'll try and get as many people as I can to come, so don't be late, okay? Don't be late.
I'll be there. The community center's on the south side. I've marked it on your map.
Thanks, Thomas. Well then, see you tomorrow.
Is there something here that you want to check out?
We need to be at the community center by 1500 today.
Just think of talking in front of all those people. What do you think, Zach?
It's going to get fun.